Hi, soccer friends. Let's start with a little warm up. I'm going to always face you, so we'll mix it up a little bit. We'll start with backward, easy jog, and then coming forward, I'll still face you. Here you go. One more time. Backward. And forward. Let's go a little zigzagging. So, lateral. High knees backwards and high knees forward. Same thing for butt kicks. Let's start backwards. Do a little bit of back kicks first. Back, 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 now let's go for high front kicks. Let's do some skipping. First backwards. And let's open the gate. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Close the gate. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Couple jump squats. Good. Shake it up. Let's do a couple of sprints. So backward, forward. At first, just 50%. 50%. Let's go 75%. And let's go full speed. All right. Calf raises. Ankle rotations. Side. Other leg. Other side for this leg. Good. Let's go for the core area. Few rotations. Let's go core twist or side twist. In the doubles. And then we can do tilts. So up and down. Good now. Pass the head, pass the head, pass the shoulder, pass the shoulder, and then maximum bend. Maximum bend. Good. Loosen up, chest and back. Open pose, open pose. All arm rotation, shoulder rotation, the shoulder. Backward, and then let's go forward. And finally, our neck, head rotation. And the other one. Now shake, and we're ready to go. For our trapping of the day, we're going to do a drill where one of the two players is going to do a throw-in and the other is going to first receive the ball, so trap it, and then trap it in one of two spots. This spot is going to be a static trap because you're moving backward, and that one is going to be a dynamic trap going forward, possibly to a flex. All right, let's see it. So you choose, right? In this passing drill today, we're going to do something a little more advanced. In general, what we have done is the passer dictates the direction of the ball. So if I'm the passer, I decide for my targets and I choose them and I send the ball. In this particular drill, we're going to have a situation where the receiver is the one dictating the ball to the passer. What does that mean? That we have three cones this side and three cones on that side. So the receiver is going to move to one of the other two open cones, and the passer has to see where the receiver is going to, and of course then pass the ball. So you have to pass with your head up, or at least you have to glance up in order to find your receiver, and then the receiver is going to do the same thing. So it's going to be a continuous pass back and forth and a continuous moving from cone to cone. So you cannot stay static on one cone. You have to move to one of the other two open cones. All right.
Cool.
All right. Seems to be that the right timing for this is when you pass the ball, you stay static until your partner makes the first contact. Then you start moving to the new cone because they're going to be looking at you and you're going to be maybe a third of the way. They're going to make contact and pass to you when you're about halfway or two-thirds of the way, and you're actually going to receive it at the right time when you're at the next cone. Okay. It almost becomes audible where you're like, you hit the trap, you move. We're gonna have a little dribbling challenge between Pat and I, and he laid out an exact, an exact same court. So the orange court starts with this cone, and that cone actually doesn't end because we keep going for 30 seconds. And we're zigzagging to the cones. Pat has the white cone, okay? So we start at the same time. We have a countdown of 30 seconds, and we have to keep dribbling next to each other. So we're going to feel a little bit of the pressure and a little bit of a rush, and we'll see who can get more lengths, okay, in 30 seconds. So when I say lengths, it means getting from one orange cone or white cone to the other. That'll count as 1 point. So there is one, coming back is two, three, four, et cetera, et cetera. You get the idea. All right, 30 seconds is the first challenge. Second, all right, go. I did it 4 times, but because it touched the cone, I got to take a half a point off, so I finished with 3.5.
I touched the cone, so I got 2.5.
All right. Our shooting challenge is going to be goal to goal, and we're going to start. So we set 2 goals, and we're going to shoot. Pat and I are going to shoot at each other, where we're actually going to, and we're going to do it for about 5 minutes. But we're going to do it so that we are defenders and not goalies. So we can stand in the goal, and we can deflect it with our head, with our, I don't know, shoulder, back, foot, but we cannot use our hands. So let's see how it goes.
Go.
Oh. This one is a super quick coordination and hands drill, so you do it with a partner. It's a goalie drill. And what we're going to do is Pat and I are going to stand in front of each other, one ball each, and then we're going to toss the ball at increasing speed, and we have to calculate it, basically catch it and throw it at the same time. So our eyes have to be both on the ball and on our partner, and we're going to get hopefully faster and faster.
Now do this though.
We have another type of pyramid run, and this is going to be a combination of a physical drill, like a push-up, like an ab, like a squat, like a hop, and then a backward sprint and a forward sprint. So our pyramid is going to be like this. I'm gonna do a drill, some kind of one of those 5 choices, and then I'm gonna sprint back to the orange cone and sprint forward to the orange cone. So back pedaling forward. So there's gonna be 5 of those. Then I'm gonna do a second round where I increase the amount of running. So I'm gonna basically my running is gonna be back pedal to the orange, forward to the white, back pedal to the blue, sprint to the white. Okay, so the blue is another probably 10 yards back. And then the final round, we're going to go back to the first. So it's going to be a minute pyramid. So we're back to white, orange, white. Okay. And the 5 patterns that we're going to do, or the 5 mini drill that we're going to do, is going to be a 5 push-up, then a 5 squat, and 5 hops over the cone. Okay. So it's 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. And Then it's gonna be an ab drill where we're actually gonna do 5 sit-ups, and finally we're gonna be doing a back drill. Okay. So let's get started. 5 push-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, that's 1. Now we're gonna do 5 squats. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. Now we're gonna do the squat, the hops. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. Now we're gonna do some sit-ups. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And finally, superheroes for the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. That was a great workout. Did a lot of running, a lot of different things. Worked our legs, our lower back, our abs. So time to do a nice thorough stretch. I like to start from the top. So let's go into stretching our necks for about 5 seconds. Neck for the 5 seconds. All right, let's go to the back and the shoulder and the tricep. Just a few seconds. Make sure you're pushing past the elbow. If you're pushing here, you're just bending the elbow, okay? So this side. Okay. Maybe a little open and close. Make sure especially the opening. Okay. A little bit of tilting. Now we're holding in the warm-up. We were not. So let me go back a little bit. We're just holding the position. Keep it stretched. Okay. A few seconds this side. Okay, now on the ground, you can do this one. Put your hips a little. You're stretching your abs and your hip flexors. Okay, another one that it's hip flexors, but mostly quad, is this. So if you want to stretch the quad, you grab more at the ankle height, at the bottom of the shin, basically. Okay. If you want to do more of the hip flexor, you bring your knee backwards. Okay. Same thing. Grab at the ankle height. Okay. Pull a little bit and start moving the knee backward to engage the hip flexor. All right. Now instead, if you want to do the shin, grab the tip of your foot. Okay. That'll do more of the shin. You're pulling the tip of the foot. The foot on the other side. All right, now we're going the back of the leg. If you want to do the calf, do this one. You can do it with hands on the ground, that works too. And they'll do almost like the full leg. Now if you want to isolate the calf and the Achilles, then you're going to bend your knee a little bit. And you go to the other one, so first straight leg to engage the whole leg. You bend to do more of the calf and Achilles. Let's let's go to hamstrings a little bit. Don't exaggerate here because they have been pulling a lot. So you want to make sure that they're flexible, but that they're not hyperextended. Okay, you can also hang. Now if you want to engage the glutes, you bend your knees a little bit and go a little further. Now it's more of the glutes that are stretching. Good.
Finally, maybe the inner thighs a little bit. So you go slowly and you hold. Slowly and you hold on this side. Now these ones, they should all be like more like 30 seconds. So you hold for a longer time. Right now, for the sake of the video, I'm doing them shorter. And the other side. Okay. And if you want to just loosen up your ankles a little bit, release them. Nice and slow, full motion. You can also do a little bit of like really light jogging. You know, if you're on a field, take off your shoes, massage your feet, and that's about it. Keep working hard. Keep appreciating the opportunities we have to practice, to improve on our skills, and enjoy the rest.